Les codes. OK. Ce dernier théorème states that any linear circuit containing several voltages and resistances can be replaced by just one single voltage in a series with a resistance connected across the load. In other words, it is possible to simplify any electrical circuit, no matter how complex, to an equivalent two-terminal circuit with just a single constant voltage source in series with a resistance or impedance connected to the load, as shown below. Now, that paragraph is written in English. So let me explain. So, what we are saying, ladies and gentlemen, is that when you have a circuit complex, you can have a complex circuit like this, and your interest is here. Okay? What the engineer is saying is that you can open at this point and this point. Okay? And everything here in this complicated part should be or can be reduced. Okay? All this can be reduced to a Fevenin's circuit. How does the Fevenin's circuit look like? The whole of this can be reduced. Think of what it does. We can call the business that is. There's too much noise in the background. Can someone mute his mic? No. Okay, bring me wood. So, gentlemen, this complication here can be reduced to a single voltage source in a series to a resistance. And then you can connect back your resistance in question or impedance. So the whole idea with the Fevenin's is to ensure that this complication here is reduced to this R Fevenin's and the Fevenin's. In some question, they'll just say deduce a Fevenin's circuit. That is a Fevenin's circuit from this here. Okay? Or they'll say, find B Fevenin's, find R Fevenin's. That is the Fevenin's theorem. So the idea is, all this complication here, this one here, has to reduce to this. Okay, put it here. Okay? Is that understood? Now, what about Venoto's theory? Okay? Venoto's theory is similar to Fedeli's, but there are few differences. So Norton's theorem also, it is where you have a complicated circuit like this one here. Then you have to reduce this complicated circuit. Here, in Fedeli's, we have a voltage source. In Norton, we have a current source. Now, here we have a voltage source in series to the equivalent resistance. Here, it will be current source in parallel. So, the Norton's theorem will look like this. The Norton's circuit. So that is what happens. In Norton, the resistance, the Norton resistance is in parallel to the current source. In Fedeli's, the Fedeli's resistance is in series to the Fedeli's source. Ladies and gentlemen, that marks the end of Venoton and Fedeli's. Going further,
sir.
Yes.
If we still have time, asking if you can repeat on Fedeli's.
We have to solve a question. What do you mean when you say I should repeat? I repeated the statement which I was saying.
No, the explanation, reason being that we had the issues to log in, so we missed something there.
You watch the video. Is that fair enough?
Thank you.
Because my interest now is if we can solve a question, one on Fedeli's and another one on Norton.
Okay, sir.
Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
So you can read here. This is what I was saying. You can have a linear network here containing several EMFs and resistors. This can reduce the voltage source and the resistors. Voltage of the system and resistors of the system in series to the resistors there. Here, everything is in series here. But when you come to Norton, everything is in parallel. In parallel.
You can't see.
Yes.
He's explaining this side.
You are not able to see my screen.
Yes. This one.
This screen. Mm-hmm. Yes.
What are you seeing right now?
The board is clear now.
Yeah.
You can't see my laptop.
No.
No.
Okay. Okay. Can you see it now?
Yes.
What can you see?
Notes.
You can see the notes. Please. Are you seeing the board or are you seeing the notes? Are you seeing the board or are you seeing my laptop?
The board is there, yes.
Are you able to see my laptop?
We can't see the laptop.
We are seeing the notes.
Yeah, but she's asking.
Okay, what can you read? Okay, read what you are seeing.
Not on.
Is an, not on the black.
Yes, okay. Oh, this
guy. I'm saying, read what you are seeing.
Newton's theorem is an analytical method used to change a complex circuit into a simple equivalent circuit.
Is that what you are all seeing?
Yes.
No.
Who is saying no?
Here.
What are you seeing, Mr. Kunika?
The circuit diagram yourself. The other, what is on the laptop is invisible. Unless if it is brought maybe closer to, you know.
Mm-hmm. No. There's something. There is something wrong with your settings. Are you using a laptop or a phone?
The laptop is the one that had the issues. Now we have switched to the phone.
Answer the question. Are you using a laptop or a phone?
The phone, sir.
Thank you. No wonder.
Yeah, back then we try to take it in again.
No, it's okay.
He wants us to be seeing this.
Mm-hmm. This is a laptop now.
Yes.
You are seeing it now.
Yes.
Is it moving?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Okay, listen. What is in the book is about 8 pages, which I've summarized into 2 pages. And the basic procedure is here in how we should be able to answer a question on what? On Norton. Or feathers. So, can we proceed by looking at an example in feathers? Permission to look at an example in feathers.
We can proceed.
We can proceed, sir.
Thank you. Marema. Ngati Marema ngati uze nase tinogona.
This one. Double click.
Just wait for the question. I'm looking for a nice question. Okay. Let me just draw the question on the board. I hope you are able to see the body.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Thank you.
So for them down.
Everything you are saying there is being recorded, and I'll post it on YouTube, and the whole world will be able to get what you are saying. So make sure that you are speaking sense. Thank you. Can you look at the question?
Yes, sir, we are ready.
Good. So, how do you solve such a question? Are we together? So, step one. Remove the RL. That's the first step you do. So, when you remove the RL, what are you going to do? Eight in kilo ohms, 4 in kilo ohms,
8, 4, 8.
Then you remember that. Is that okay? Do we agree?
Yes.
Yes. That's the one. Are we together? I'll be a bit slow because I'm not going to repeat. Once you do that, okay, you should measure step two. Can you read? What does it say?
Measure the open circuit.
Measure the open circuit.
Circuit voltage.
Okay. So?
The open circuit voltage.
Correct. So, what does that mean? Okay. Although we are saying measure, you are simply calculating. Okay.
Yeah.
We are simply calculating here. What is the V feelings? I will get it. What we mean by saying measure, we are simply saying here where you have removed the resistor, if you were to bring your voltmeter here, the lead of a voltmeter here, how much is it going to read? That's your V feelings. That is the interpretation. Excellent. Okay. So how much voltage is it going to be there? So what is happening there is that since we have opened here, in some books, they will simply do this and input this. Find the V feathers. Where you have removed the resistor, put your voltmeter there. Okay? Step one, remove the load resistor. And step two, where you have removed the load resistor, can you measure the voltage there? That's the interpretation. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
So, how do we measure the voltage there?
Measure the open circuit.
Where? Yeah, the open circuit. Oh, open.
I'm waiting for an answer. You people, you are very intelligent. You have done instrumentation as well. Okay, good. So, for the sake of time, here is the issue. When it is open here, current will move from here. Is that okay? Here, like this. That's all. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
It won't go here. Reason this side has been open. Open. Is that okay?
Yes.
Are you with me? So current will not flow through the edge. Why? Because there is an open here. So what the current will just move through the top before and back. Are we together? So, how much current is that? Our current layer will be equal to the 48 volts divided by the 12 plus the what? The 4. Are we together? Because when we open here, 12 and 4 are in series. Do you agree?
Yes.
The 8 is no longer under consideration because it is open here. So when current leaves the source here, it will only see 12 and 4. And it will see 12 and 4 in series. In series. Are we together?
Yes.
So, what is current? Current is equal to voltage over resistance. What is the voltage here? 48 volts. What is the resistance? 12 plus what? Plus 4. So we are going to have 48 over 16 kilo ohms. And our I will be equal to 3 milli amps. Do you agree?
Yes.
So if the current is 3 milli amps, you agree? So if your current is 3 milli amps, where is the milli coming from? Because this is zero. So it's 48 divided by 16,000. You are going to get 0.003, which is 3 milli amps. Are we together? Now that you know the current source, the voltage, what this voltmeter will measure is simply the voltage drop on the 4 ohms. And our V then will therefore be equal to the current multiplied by the resistor, which is this 4 here. What is our current? 3 times 10 to the power negative 3, which is milli, multiplied by the resistor, which is what? 4 times 10 to the power 3. What we get here? 3 multiplied by 4, you are going to get what? 12 volts. Ladies and gentlemen, that is your V Fevenis. It seems the people are tired, eh?
Oh, following, sir.
You are following?
Yes, sir.
Good. So, we have found the V Fevenis. What is the next step? Step 3. We have to get the what? The R Fevenis. Just the way the question is put there. We have to get the what? The R Fevenis. So, I'll write here, step 3. We have to determine our R Fevenis. Now please, follow me very clearly on how to determine our R Fevenis. Determining our R Fevenis, we have already opened the circuit. So we have 12 here, 8 here, 4 here. Where there is voltage source, you short. Just like in what? In a superposition. And thereafter, you come and put your ohmmeter here and measure the resistor. The resistance. Are we together? So all you are doing here, we are going to put it like this. We say When you look into this, what resistance are you seeing? That is your other favorites. Very, very simple. What can you see here? 12 is in parallel to 4. Do you agree?
Yes.
So it will be 12 in parallel to 4. 12 times 4 over 12 plus 4. What we get?
Three months.
Okay.
Yes.
And that was 3 months is in the series 1 to 8. So our other is 3 plus 8. 11. Anyway, it will be kilo. Since all these are in kilo. Are we together? Then you now draw your feminine circuit. So our feminine circuit will always be the feminine. And then here, we have the loads. In this case, this was 5 kilo ohms. What is your other fetanis? 11 kilo ohms. What is your B fetanis? What did we get as our B fetanis?
V. 12 watts.
It was 12 watts. Thank you. That is all. And then they say, find the current. This is the series circuit. Namugari Kulowa, you cannot fail to find this. Because here now, our total is simply, so this was step 4. Step 4, you draw the circuit. So our total there, our R equivalent is simply 11 plus 5, which gives us what? 6 kilo ohms. Then our V is what? 12 volts. Then what will be our IL? The current through the resistor will be the voltage 12 over the equivalent resistor, which is 16 in a kilo. So our answer will be mean 12 divided by 16. 0.75 amps. Ladies and gentlemen, that marks the end of a question on favorites. Can we go to Norton? Yeah. Or we can do Norton tomorrow?
Tomorrow, sir.
This is 3 minutes to 3 hours. So, I want you to